I'm Dr. Janine Nkosi. I am a sociologist, an educator, a community organizer, and I get to work alongside my students and so many incredible community partners to engage in social action that strives to advance land and housing justice for everyone. Preparing my students to engage in social action starts by creating a safe, secure, loving classroom space where students can grow in courage and confidence and be brave enough to step outside of their comfort zone into meaningful work that they never imagined they'd be doing in a college classroom. To try to create a space where students can be their authentic selves. I encourage them to bring multiple linguistics, to bring their family lessons, their cultural knowledge, and their ancestral wisdom into our shared learning space. I think that I teach to advance social action and strive to create a meaningful learning experience because, in part, I was a first-generation college student and a mom of two small children. It was not easy. I had about a 10th grade education, but even still, that foundation, it was really fractured because I moved around a lot as a kid. My children were my inspiration to figure out how to enroll in college, how to struggle through to graduation despite every setback that you can imagine. When I think back and I reflect on how I was able to make it through, I see the faces of the teachers, the professors, the counselors who were a part of my village. I also reflect on how vital it was that everything that I was learning in the classroom could be applied to my own life to create something better for my family and for my community. When I first started teaching at Fresno State back in 2011, my first class had a service learning component, and it was perfect because it gave me the opportunity to connect what we were doing in the classroom to meaningful community-based work. Over the years, I have engaged in an ongoing process of reflecting and growing to transform my teaching and research into an applied approach that strives to advance human rights, like having access to a safe, secure, healthy home in a healthy, thriving neighborhood. When we have all of our basic human needs met, our homes can be a place where we create beautiful memories with the people that we love. Without safe, stable housing, everything else in our lives is at risk. Every semester in my Sociology 3 class, I get to work alongside my students and an amazing group of community leaders and grassroots community organizations to do everything that we can to advance land and housing justice for everyone in Fresno. Start with an examination of our own housing stories and our family history and our relationship to the land that we all occupy. Then we examine the current state of the housing crisis. From there, we explore the political, the social, the economic underlying causes of what has created the system of land and housing as we know it today. And throughout the semester, while we're learning all of this, students are also learning the fundamentals of social action. So that from literally like week one all the way to week 16, we are taking action on what we're learning. So in the spirit of applied teaching and learning that centers the voices of students and community, I created a video that brings student voices front and center. The video contains a small collection of pictures and videos and news clips to give you a glimpse into how I've been engaging with my students over the last 10 plus years to advance land and housing justice. This is not a model for how to teach. It's just a glimpse into what my students and I have been doing together over the last 10 plus years. I hope that, you know, maybe somebody watches this video and they become inspired and they want to begin a journey of reflecting on their own teaching, and they want to reimagine their curriculum and what they do with their students, and they want to begin to live more deeply into a way of teaching that truly advances human rights.
My biggest takeaway from applied community-based learning is getting to see that application is everything. And I see that in my work every day as well. Students are able to retain something a lot stronger when they're actually applying what they're learning. Having purpose behind everything that we were doing and getting to kind of see the fruits of that labor impact the community was a really eye-opening experience for me, and it has really shaped the way that I approach my work.
Making the decision of public transportation, I encourage you to take the bus one of these days.
Yeah.
You know, just to feel our experience as a student, as a resident, to get your groceries, doctor appointments, education. You know what I'm saying?
And I thought Fresno was supposed to be one city, but what I've noticed is that it's really two cities: North Fresno and South Fresno. Neighborhoods in South Fresno have disproportionately lower parks and open space compared to the North. The life expectancy in South Fresno is more than 20 years lower than in North Fresno.
Plan to clean up Fresno's rundown neighborhoods, won approval from the City Council today. Require property owners to clean up visible blight like garbage and boarded up windows. Fresno State Professor Janine Nkosi was among those who pushed the ordinance. She says it's critical to identify vacant properties as soon as possible.
Because vacant properties in the city of Fresno are currently costing us millions of dollars. Nearly $500,000 in 2014 alone for vacant property fires. So it puts the lives of firefighters at risk. It puts the lives of residents at risk.
We analyzed thousands of court records. We have found that evictions happen at a higher rate in the Central Valley than in anywhere else in California.
Hello, everyone. My name is Brene Walker. I'm a student here at Fresno State. I just wanted to welcome everyone and say thank you for showing up to this really important press conference on our housing crisis and this North Star vision we have to transform housing as we know it across the Central Valley. We are students, community members, advocates, organizers, and impacted people. We are the ones who can change the future for those who come after us.
We have been actively reimagining learning and education as we work toward addressing social justice issues, specifically housing justice. There's not a lot of space for creativity, discussion, or just, you know, service learning. And so the stories that you're going to hear about today, the people you'll meet today, and the work that we're doing, it turns that system on its head.
Our own perspective on what we were learning about. So about like homes guaranteed, we would, okay, who's struggling with housing? Who's doesn't know their renter's rights? We made sure that we took all of the information that we learned and applied it to our own lives. And we didn't waste time doing worksheets and stuff like that. It was all just having a conversation and making sure that everybody could relate their lives to what we were learning. Even if you weren't struggling, you would be able to recognize your privilege and acknowledge that and make sure that you were supporting your classmates who were struggling during that time. So that's how I feel, that we all knew that it wasn't a place for judgment. We weren't gonna judge each other based off of our housing and anything that we were going through at the time, and that we were all gonna uplift each other and support one another during those times. So in the beginning, I was really nervous and kind of, I just didn't feel like it was right to share those things. But now at the end, literally at the city council meeting, I cried in front of everybody. Like, it was just so like powerful and uplifting.
Like, honestly, like at the beginning of class, when we like joined the Zoom meeting and then we'd hear the music in the background and also like the check-in questions so we could all feel connected. And then after that, when we just read over some of the community agreements, and then during throughout the whole space we would like learn about everything that that we had to do in the community cares or in the homes guaranteed. And then at the end, when we were debriefed by like doing meditation or maybe just like reflecting on what we had done throughout the day.
The most meaningful part for me was the action portion of the class. So I spoke at City Council on two different occasions about housing justice, and it was just really nice to have that experience. You know, prior to this, as like a young individual, I don't think many of us know that we have like the ability to speak at like City Council. So it was really nice to be able to do that. And not only like, it wasn't just me speaking, I'm speaking alongside 10 to 20 to at our last one, hundreds of other people who are all fighting for the same cause. So that's just like such a powerful thing to do. And as someone highlighted earlier, they saw us all in the newspaper. And so it's just so cool to be a part of these huge actions and know that we're really making a difference in our community. Whereas I feel like in like previous classes, it's like, oh, okay, you learn the definition, you move on with your life. Whereas it's like, this is something I'm gonna tell my kids about in the future.
And if professors are feeling cautious of reimagining their course to the benefit of the students, then they shouldn't be professor. This model of teaching and learning takes confidence and persevering that is felt by students. This model of teaching also leaves unforgettable memories that last a lifetime.
Good morning, everyone. Residents from Fresno who showed up here really deep. We felt that we needed to come here today to demonstrate what an inclusive and equitable and responsive public input process would look like. I'm a regional advisor for Faith in the Valley and a professor of sociology at Fresno State. And I am an expert in Fresno's housing crisis. Not just because I have spent the last 10 years of my life literally researching the problems, researching the scope of the crisis, and also researching the solutions, but because I've moved 35 times in my life. I have lived in practically every one of your districts. I have lived in all kinds of housing, slum housing to equitable housing. And it's an injustice when some of us are living in safe and secure housing while some folks are unhoused and unsheltered and out in the cold. And we are here because we want you to put housing on the agenda and prioritize it. We have held countless listening sessions. We have been doing a public input survey over the last year. We've been phone banking. We have been knocking on doors. And the number one thing that we hear across district, across age, across gender, across party line, is that housing is the number one priority that people want to see a solution to. People want investments in youth, investments in health and well-being, investments in housing stabilization, things like universal basic income. Please listen to Fresno residents. We are here today in person, and we are even stronger on Zoom. And we're coming in 2022. If we have to form a tenant union, if we have to show up every single day to City Council until you hear us, we are willing to do whatever it takes to make sure that everyone in the city of Fresno has access to safe, accessible, sustainable, and deeply and permanently affordable housing.
My name is Erika Lara. I'm a first-generation college student at Fresno State. I am a Latina, a daughter of Salvadoran immigrants. I currently live in Fresno District 4. See, how many college students are drowning in loans? And if anybody relates, the audience can raise their hands or their signs. How many of us work two jobs and struggle to pay rent? How many of us have heard that our friends or families are being evicted? How many of us see our hardworking parents contemplating whether to pay the rent or put food on our tables? How many of us see our family members who work in fields struggling to have the money for the next rent bill because the minimum wage we get paid is not even close to enough? You see how many hands? We are all here today, and many more of us on Zoom, to ensure the city of Fresno puts rent control, just cause for eviction, and right to counsel in effect immediately.
A community united will never be divided. A community united will never be divided. A community united will never be divided.
Together, we have written countless letters to the editor, op-eds, done interviews. We have helped to pass historic housing policies. We've secured millions of dollars in funding that goes directly to creating safe, secure housing for Fresno residents. I am just incredibly proud of the work that we've been able to do together over the past 10 years.
When the glory comes,